So I think the next few years are going to be exciting in seeing the way in which polygenic risk scores are utilised. I think individual diseases will be selected, the ones where we have demonstrated in a research setting that the polygenic risk scores have a high utility. And those polygenic risk scores will then be taken into almost like a clinical trial setting, inviting people to have a polygenic risk score and communicating the results of those risk scores to them.
In the next 10 to 20 years, we're going to see an enormous wave of applications of polygenic risk scores. One application is through a stratification of the population, really targeting the individuals most at risk for either early intervention or for early treatment. And I really think that in the future, a polygenic risk score will be seen as having a cholesterol test, for example, or having an X-ray.
So what I see in the future is that genetic information will be available on everyone. It'll be part of our routine medical care, that information will be part of our care record, and it can be interrogated any time a patient comes for a consultation. And we'll use that for identifying what the best medication is, that's in pharmacogenetics. We'll use it for prognosis of the disorder, and we'll use it for identifying what other disorders the patient might be at risk of that they could do something about now.
遺伝的な因子と現在使われていますようなリスク因子というのを組み合わせて、より精緻な発症率の推定やそれによるリスクをより正確に知るということは、やはり予防医療の中で重要な役割を果たすのかなというふうに考えております。
Also, we can use the PRS to drive the screening of the population or the high risk or the moderate risk population for different kind of diseases. And even for the general population, we can use the PRS to do some prediction and make almost everyone has a better or a more healthy life plan.